And for today's video, I'm going to share with you the history of my beloved school, City College of Calapan. So, let's start! The city of Calapan today is not just known for its thriving industries in the trade of commerce, but in various sectors as well. Education, for one, has been undergoing reforms and continues to receive and support from the city government. And being one of its flagship programs, this social sector has been given much attention and priority by the administration with the philosophy that education serves as the key to poverty alleviation and social mobility. In 2003, the one who first came up with the idea of putting up an LGU-managed tertiary education institution is no other than Mayor Arnen C. Panaligan. Initial stops were then made such as study tours in the city of Tagaytay in order to observe how the said city put their local college. But due to his assumption to higher government position, the project was put into staff. It took 2 years to continue the project by City Mayor Carlos Bucal. In 2005, he formed a technical working group composed of personnel from the different departments: Urban Planning and Development Department, City Education Department, and City Accounting and Internal Audit Department. The study tours to the City College of Tagaytay and Pamantasan ng Lungsod ng Maynila were conducted. The technical working group also coordinated with the Commission on Higher Education, MIMARAPA, regarding institutionalization of a city college for the city. Honorable Victor Olayan Jr., the City Councilor and Sangguniang Panglungsod Committee Chairman on Education, was a partner in said initiative in order to look upon the legislative side of the project. In-depth analysis with regard to its financial feasibility, its mode of operation, legal basis, and other aspects were then taken into consideration. A public hearing in coordination with the Sangguniang Panglungsod was also held. Eventually, the group came up with a report and draft ordinance was submitted to former Mayor Bucal. With the advent of the 2007 election, the project was again put aside. Based from the reports and studies made by technical working group formed by the former Mayor Bucal, former Mayor Paulino Salvador Doy C. Lechon, advised former City Education Officer Marilyn E. Manigpas, former Urban Planning and Development Coordinator Darwinio Villarosa with Dr. Rene M. Calocar, to work on the project in order to meet the prescribed timetable of its implementation. A committee on the establishment of the City College was organized, headed by the former City Administrator Antonio Jojo S. Perez. Other set of city officials was sought to help, headed by the former Vice Mayor Rafael Infantado, Councilor Jojo Malapitan, Chairman of the Committee on Education of Sangguniang Panglungsod, and City Trade and Industry Joey Benter, who devoted their time and talent to come up with a feasibility study. This time, another tour was done at Pamantasan ng Lungsod ng Urdaneta in Pangasinan to observe how the college became successful in its operation. Former City Education Officer Mrs. Marilyn E. Manigbas administered a random sampling survey among young Calapenos and the course they would want the City College to offer. Spearheaded by former Vice Mayor Rafael Infantado, City Ordinance No. 14 was unanimously passed and approved on March 12, 2008, which finally paved the way for the operation of the City College. The said ordinance also amended the scholarship program, stating that city government will no longer send scholars to other schools. The new set of scholars who will pass the scholarship examination 2008 to 2009 will be the initial batch of the enrollees at the City College. During the first semester, there were 124 enrollees and general education subjects were offered. Offices such as the one occupied by the former mayor Armand C. Panaliga and the Technology and Livelihood Development Center, or TLDC, and the urban planning were used as classroom by the first-year students, while the former civil registrar's office was used as the City College Administrator's office. The first batch of the City College of Calapan faculty for the first semester was composed of 11 members, namely Rene M. Calucar, City Human Resource Management and Development Officer, Ms. Marilyn E. Manigbas, City Education Officer, Amormio CJS Benther, MPA, City Trade Industry Officer, Mr. Marvin L. Panahon, City Youth and Sports Development Officer, Dr. Fe B. Abaca, Mr. Joselito Bautista, Project Development Officer 1, Mr. Ronald F. Cantos, Licensing Officer 2, Mr. Jerry A. De Los Reyes, Project Development Assistant, Attorney Antonio S. Perez Jr., City Administrator, Attorney Rafael F. Infantando, City Vice Mayor, and Attorney Paulino Salvador C. Lechon, City Mayor. Before the opening of the second semester, the Board of Trustees met and decided on the course to be offered based on the result of the survey and felt need of the community. The students were given the opportunity to decide what course to take based on the following offerings: Bachelor of Elementary Education with Specialization in Special Education, Bachelor of Science in Information Systems, Bachelor of Science in Hotel and Restaurant Management, Bachelor of Science in Tourism Management. In 2011, three new programs were offered, namely Bachelor in Library and Information Science, Bachelor of Secondary Education, Major in Mathematics, Major in Physical Science. At present, the City College of Calapan is now serving six courses with seven programs and their corresponding program heads. Initially, the college was awarded with TVET certification from TESDA in 2011 to eligibly offer housekeeping and C2 course. Eventually, 30 students graduated in the said program together with the first batch of baccalaureate graduates. The 21st graduates of PE-Ed major in special education gave pride and honor to the academic community after being recognized with 100% passing percentage in the licensure examination for teachers or LET, conducted last September 30, 2012. It is indeed another milestone in the unceasing endeavor of the City College to deliver quality education. This high passing rate of education students remains at present. In addition, the BLIS graduates also get a high percentage in their licensure examination for several years, which adds to the pride and honor of the institution. Moreover, the City College of Calapan also opened its grade 11 and 12 as part of the institution's tertiary education programs. In accordance with the implementation of the K-12 curriculum of the Department of Education, which inevitably established linkages between and among public and private institutions locally. So that's all for today. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Bye! Whenever you tell me I'm pretty, that's when the hunger really hits me. Your little heart goes pitter-patter. I want your liver on a platter.